In this edition of Inside Blue Host Football, we kick off the 2015 season against another FBS opponent. We'll have a visit with Coach Harold Nichols, take a look at the highlights against the Red Hawks of Miami of Ohio, and a lot more in this kickoff edition of Inside Blue Host Football.
Inside Blue Host Football is brought to you by Founders Federal Credit Union. Relax, you're with Founders. By Self Regional Healthcare, we bring advanced care closer. By Fats Cafe of Clinton, making your tailgate deliciously easy. And by Coca-Cola, the official soft drink of Presbyterian College.
We welcome you to our kickoff edition of Inside Blue Host Football for the 2015 season. Welcome back, Coach Harold Nichols. And Coach, so much success last year, and you kick off this season again against an FBS opponent, and this is becoming a regular thing for your Blue Hosts now.
Yeah, you know, I think there's some merit playing up like that, especially mm-hmm. early in the year. It gives you an opportunity to, you know, kind of see where you're at and kind of get a little bit of a measuring stick of where you're at as a football team. You know, I knew going up and playing a really good Miami, Ohio team with a great tradition, mm-hmm. Coach Martin going into his second year, there'd be quite the challenge, and certainly was that. I think, you know, coaches always worry about first ball games, you know, line of scrimmage penalties, turnovers, and those kind of things, and we certainly did have our fair share of that Saturday afternoon. Mm-hmm. But, you know, some things that, you know, we can take from the game that I think we can build on, you know, where, you know, I think teams will make the most improvement from week one to week two than probably they will the rest of the year.
Yeah.
So, you know, again, you know, some things that we can build off of. Obviously disappointed in that we did not play better, because I do think we had some opportunities there in the second half, you know, to go up and have an opportunity to win the football game. But obviously we didn't do that, and credit goes to Miami, Ohio.
Well, Tam Garrett starts for the third time as the season-opening quarterback, did fairly well. Your team had two trips inside the red zone, and despite, you know, having two turnovers there, it was a game where your defense played well, your offense was able to move the ball, and it at least showed on the field that, hey, we can play with these guys.
Yeah, I think our team has some confidence.
Right.
Was really proud of the way Tam played for most of the mm-hmm. game. You know, I'm sure, you know, he would like to have that interception back in the red zone.
But that's only one play, yeah.
Exactly. But I do think that, you know, as the game went on, he kind of settled down and got us in the right play and did some really good things.
Well, no doubt the defense was all over the field as well. Let's go ahead and dive in and take a look at the first half highlights, the Blue Hose and the Red Hawks of Miami.
Game highlights are brought to you by Matt Davis State Farm Insurance. Like a good neighbor, Matt Davis and State Farm are there.
All right, we're going to start off with defensive highlights instead of first half here. Start off, we got him kind of pinned down, and there's Donnell Williams, you know, our all-conference linebacker coming in, making a great play, kind of sniffs it out. And he's just got a nose for the football, tackle for loss there on the first drive. Come back here later on in the first half, and they run a little play-action pass, and there's Snoop, you know, does a great job stripping the ball. Deron Dickey, being very opportunistic, picks it up and gets some blockers out in front of him. This was kind of a big play in the game.
That's right.
I really felt like that, you know, kind of picked up our sidelines a little bit, and it kind of helped our confidence. But a nice job by Deron and Snoop there. here's the official here. I tell you what, he was out there a lot in this
game. A lot of laundry on the field.
There sure was. There sure was. But I do think at the end of the day, that's something we got to do a better job of cleaning up as a staff. Here's the end zone shot of that same play, and you know they got a little play action pass here, and you know Snoop does a good job keeping the guy in front of him, but probably a little bit too much cushion, ends up stripping the ball. Deron's pretty opportunistic. We got Jerry Burke, our redshirt freshman linebacker. There's Ed Britt out in front, and does a nice job on the return here and sets us up with great field position. Got the ball on first and 10 at the plus 25. Here we are. I think this is the fumble play where Obina picks it up. We got our backs against the wall, and knife in, does a nice job right there. Big stop. And we saw that a lot last year out of our defense.
Sure did.
You know, our kids just seem to have a little bit of mental toughness here, you know, with their backs against the wall, that they just believe that they're going to be able to make a play. There's Deron and the defensive end in there making a play, and Obina being very opportunistic.
Well, the defense many times in that game playing lights out, and Coach, you talked about it, we saw it. The defense is still pretty strong for the Blue Hose.
Yeah, I think so. I think that's going to be a strength of our team. I mean, from a leadership standpoint, we've got the most returning starters back there, so... with much is given, much is expected. You know?
Right.
So I
Good
think
point.
That, you know, and they showed up. Now, I don't think they played a great game. I think they did some really good things in the game. But, you know, in order for us to get to where we want to be as a program, you know, we're going to have to make great improvement from week one to week two. And, you know, Miami of Ohio is a really good team. They got great skill, and, you know, the quarterback had a really good arm and had a really good idea where to throw the football. So we'll make some adjustments and hopefully be better next week.
All righty, Coach. Let's go ahead and take a timeout. When we come back, it's the offense's turn. Take a look at special teams and maybe the hit of the game. All that ahead here on Inside Blue Hose Football.
This portion of Inside Blue Hose Football is brought to you by Matt Davis State Farm Insurance of Clinton. Like a good neighbor, Matt Davis and State Farm are there. Cooper Motor Company, sales and service of Chrysler, Jeep, Dodge, and Ram trucks since 1938. Chick-fil-A of Lawrence, home of the original chicken sandwich.
We're fighting cancer with caring, with technology, with knowledge. And now, with the Hollings Clinical Trial Network at the Medical University of South Carolina. Together, we're bringing more advanced cancer care close to home. Self-Regional Healthcare Cancer Center. We bring advanced care closer.
Going big game, buddy?
You know it.
Let's see, Gabby, we've got a big game to go to.
There she is. Ah, so how many goals are you going to score today?
10,000.
10,000?
I like it.
Grab a Bojangles Big Bow Box and feed the whole group with chicken, biscuits, fixins, and tea. Bojangles, it's bow time.
I'm a random windstorm. Shaky, 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 shaky. Shaky, shaky. And if you got cut rate insurance, you could be picking up this tab yourself. So get Allstate. You could save some cash and be better protected from mayhem like me.
Hi, this is Harold Nichols, head football coach here at Presbyterian College. Do you need some help simplifying your life? Matt Davis has helped me, and he can help you too. Go see Matt Davis and his great team at State Farm in Clinton, South Carolina. They will handle your auto, home, and life insurance so you will have more time to handle everything else in life. You could earn discounts up to 40%. Sounds like a touchdown to me.
Thank you.
As you set your financial game plan, we'll be with you every play. Relax, you're with Founders.
We welcome you back to Inside Blue Hose Football. Coach, if you will, let us take a look at the offense.
Sounds good.
Game highlights are brought to you by Matt Davis State Farm Insurance. Like a good neighbor, Matt Davis and State Farm are there.
Here we start with our offensive highlights. I think this might have been our first drive here. Again, we got a little sprint out pass, and there's DJ Wilson right there with a big catch, big first down. I really thought our offensive line played a lot better in the course of the game. I think we're more athletic, and like I say, Tam made some really good throws in the game, and there's DJ with the catch there on the boundary. Here we have got kind of a trip set with Joe Perter, our junior tight end. Again, you see the offensive line communicating there. You got a little orbit motion right there, and we get a little good crease right there with Darryl Bridges, who ended up with 125
what
yards
a game.
Rushing.
What a game for Darryl Bridges.
Played well. And, there's Joe kind of leading through. And, they kind of moved a little bit defensively, but I think we did a nice job of communicating there and getting a hat on the right hat. And, like I said, Darryl, I felt like he ran hard with the football the whole game. Here we are right here, after the lightning delay. On our scoring play, got a little bunch set out here to the field, run a little toss play to Darryl, got some good blocking out there in front, especially Ryan Bristow right here. If you look at the right tackle, number 54, who I thought played one of his best games in his career, really does a nice job searching out that linebacker and gets just enough on him so he can get Darryl into the end zone. 13-7 right here. Go to special teams, there's Tim Hartshorn, our redshirt freshman, one of our redshirt freshman kickers, does a nice job with his kick and really boots it where it's about 7 or 8 yards in the back of the end zone.
Got a cannon for a leg, doesn't
he? Yeah, did a nice job. And that's something that has not happened since I've been here. He's been able to kind of take the pressure some off of our kickoff team with a really nice kick right here into the back of the end zone. You can see it right here. And thought we played okay on special teams. I think there's a lot that we can learn from the tape and get a lot better next week.
Well, Coach, it's exciting to see the senior quarterback, Tammen Garrett, Gator, they call him. Try saying that three times. But good to see the senior have a pretty decent game.
Yeah, I thought Tam did a good job managing the game. And, he's a fifth-year senior. He's got a lot of poise and a lot of maturity mm-hmm. about him. And, again, like I say, I thought he played relatively well all game. You saw Darryl Bridges make a run there. A lot of that has to do with the offensive line too. I think we're better there. So we just got to be more productive. I think we're relatively balanced. Miami Ohio is a very physical football team on the road, hostile environment. So I think we're making progress there. Of course, we're going to be better here next week against Charlotte and down the stretch with our schedule that we've got. But proud of all those kids. I thought we did a lot better.
And special teams, that's something that you're going to look to improve on each and every week.
Right? Yeah, I didn't think we played very well at all on special mm-hmm. teams. Missed a lot of hidden yardage in the punting game. Return game is a little bit better. Mm-hmm. Missed a field goal down there going in. Can't do that. So we've got to firm up some things to be able to take advantage of what our opponents give us.
Well, one thing's for certain, and you know this as well, the blue hose will hit you. So let's go ahead and take a look at our Nichols Automotive Collision of the Week.
And here we've got the Nichols Automotive Collision of the Week, and this goes back to Obina's fumble recovery, but Deron Dickey does a nice job. Donnell Williams, huge play in the ballgame. We've got a little knife right here with Donnell kind of running through the B gap, and there's the monster, Ugani Ako, and Deron, big play, big fumble recovery, Nichols Automotive Collision of the Week.
We'd like to thank Nichols Automotive again. It's one of my favorite segments of the show, no doubt. Well, it's been an injury-plagued week one in college football, and the Blue Hose, unfortunately, were bitten by the injury bug as well. Coach, let us take a look at the Palmetto Bone and Joint Injury Report, please.
Well, thankful for all the folks there at Palmetto Bone and Joint for what they do for all of our athletic teams. Dr. Milner and his crew, they do a great job keeping our kids healthy. Unfortunately, we kind of give them a lot of business, because of the sport that we play. But, one thing coming out of this game, the injury to Blake Roberts, our running back, obviously is one that is pretty significant. Worked so hard and really kind of part of the glue of our football team. He's just such a good player and a hard-nosed throwback kind of kid.
football character.
Yeah, and I love him to death. I mean, just love the way watching play. So that's a pretty significant injury. You know, we'll get a diagnosis on exactly the extent of it. Other than that, I think that, you know, outside of a few nicks and dings, I think we're going to be okay. So
good.
You know, unfortunately, injuries are part of the game.
That's right.
And we've got kind of a next man up kind of mentality that you got to have. So, but again, you know, health is something that's very important, and you got to be a little bit lucky.
All righty, Coach. Thank you very much. Let us go ahead and take our final timeout. When we come back, well, we like to coach you about the game, and that's Coach's Corner, and then we'll take a look at next week's opponent.
You'll find them inside each huddle, on every sideline, in every classroom, on each campus, from our neighborhoods to the corner office. Student athletes from the Big South Conference serving in roles they've trained for all their lives. Leaders. The Big South Conference, developing leaders through athletics. Learn more at BigSouthSports.com.
I'm a random windstorm. Shaky, 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 shaky. Shaky, shaky. And if you got cut-rate insurance, you could be picking up this tab yourself. So get Allstate. You could save some cash and be better protected from mayhem like me.
We're fighting cancer with caring, with technology, with knowledge. And now, with the Hollings Clinical Trial Network at the Medical University of South Carolina. Together, we're bringing more advanced cancer care close to home. Self-Regional Healthcare Cancer Center. We bring advanced care closer.
As you set your financial game plan, we'll be with you every play. Relax, you're with Founders.
Going big game, buddy?
You know it.
Let's see, Gabby, we've got a big game to go to. There she is. So how many goals are you going to score today?
10,000.
10,000?
I like it.
Grab a Bojangles Big Bow Box and feed the whole group with chicken, biscuits, fixins, and tea. Bojangles, it's bow time.
Hi, this is Harold Nichols, head football coach here at Presbyterian College. Do you need some help simplifying your life? Matt Davis has helped me, and he can help you too. Go see Matt Davis and his great team at State Farm in Clinton, South Carolina. They will handle your auto, home, and life insurance so you will have more time to handle everything else in life. You could earn discounts up to 40%. Sounds like a touchdown to me.
This portion of Inside Blue Host Football is brought to you by Bojangles. It's bow time. And by Jeff Smith, Allstate Insurance of Clinton. You're in good hands with Jeff Smith and Allstate.
We welcome you back. You know he is a student, not only a coach of the game. He loves it so much. Let's get a visit with Coach Harold Nichols in Coach's Corner.
Coach's Corner is brought to you by Jeff Smith, Allstate Insurance of Clinton. You're in good hands with Allstate and Jeff Smith.
Welcome to this week's edition of Coach's Corner. I've got with me senior quarterback Caleb Griffin. He's from up in Florence in the PD area.
And we're going to talk a little bit about throwing mechanics. I know a lot of you guys really like the quarterback and like what he does on Saturday afternoons. We're going to talk to you a little bit about the mechanics of actually throwing a football. First thing I'm going to talk to you about is the grip. Now, not unlike a lot of you here watching from home, your grip really depends on the size of your hand. A lot of guys like to grip the meat of the football. Some guys with smaller hands may try to grip it a little closer to the nose. One important thing is that you want to make a good L with your forefinger and your thumb, okay, and you want to put that right in the crux of the ball. All right, you're going to grab probably the top two or three laces. Caleb's got a pretty good sized hand here, so grip's important. Also, too, you'll notice he's got a little space between his palm and the football there, because really throwing is really a fingertip related activity. It's not necessarily the palm of your hand. So fingertips is very, very important. Now, as you're dropping back, you get the center quarterback exchange and you're dropping back in the pocket like you see those guys doing on TV. Having good ball security and ball carriage is very important. We want to try to have two hands on the ball perpendicular from the ground, all right, and you just want to move the ball peck to peck, all right, as you carriage the football. And we call that good ball security or ball carriage. Now, your takeaway as you separate your hands in relation to throwing the football, really you got two mechanics. You got upper body mechanics and you got lower body mechanics. As you separate your hands, all right, as you're ready to throw the football, you want to make sure that your elbow is up. You don't want to have a flat shoulder rotation. You want to make sure your back shoulder is up. You want to make sure the ball is away from your head, okay? You don't want to have it curled up there next to your ear. You want to make sure the ball is up and away from your head, all right, as you bring your back half through. Now, the front elbow is important too, because you're going to pull the back half of your body through with your front elbow. If you've got a good arm slot as you bring the ball forward, all right, you'll get the ball to spin like you want it to. Now, hips are very important. When I finish, I want to make sure that my hips are pointed towards my target. That's a very important part of it as your lower body, because really throwing starts from the ground up. As you bring your arm through, as you rotate the ball and keep the ball away from your head, the last thing that'll touch will be probably your index finger, your forefinger right there. So as you release the football, you're going to have a good high release with your elbow high and a good finish right there as you bring your back half through. So you really got to do a good job with your lower body and your upper body keeping a good arm slap. Now here in conclusion right here and in review, good grip, good space between the palm and the ball, good ball carriage, good separation of hands, make sure your elbow's up, the ball's back away from your head, make sure your hips get pointed towards your target, good finish and follow through, good nice high release, and I guarantee you can put that to your game back at home. Caleb Griffin and good old Coach Nichols here for this edition of Coach's Corner.
Coach's Corner is brought to you by Jeff Smith, Allstate Insurance of Clinton. You're in good hands with Allstate and Jeff Smith.
Well, Coach, there's no doubt about it. To me, it looks like you really enjoy doing that segment.
I do. It's one of my favorites. You know, like I say, you got middle school kids, elementary school kids at home, and try to share a little bit of the fundamentals of the game of football.
Next week's preview is sponsored by Chick-fil-A of Lawrence, home of the original chicken sandwich.
Coach, let's talk about the 49ers of Charlotte. This is another FBS team, a team that you faced a couple of years ago here at Bailey. What have you learned about them after week one, and what have you done to prepare your kids to go up against the 49ers?
Well, I think a couple things. One, I think this is a different Charlotte team than it was 2 years ago when we played them. That was their inaugural season. I think that Coach Lambert's done a really good job of kind of building that program to where it's at now. And, they've got a lot of redshirt juniors, seniors on that team now. It's been with him now for three years, going on four. They are a fully fledged FBS team now in Conference USA. If you look at what happened in the Conference USA this past weekend, Marshall beats Purdue at home. That's a really good league, really good football. And they're a talented team. They ran 86 plays against Georgia State, had over 400 yards of offense. Matt Johnson, their quarterback, is really a good operator, and they've got some skill. The Phillips kid, their tailback's really good. Cook, their middle linebacker's their leading tackler. So they've got a lot of talented kids and kind of grown up together. We'll be playing at their place. It'll be a hostile environment at Richardson Field there in Charlotte. So You know, I think the challenges are going to become whether we can kind of play better than we did against Miami of Ohio from the standpoint of having a better line of scrimmage. You know, we had so many penalties. I mean, we had almost 14 penalties for 100 yards. You're not going to win any game.
Better look out. There's another flag now.
Yeah, that's right. I mean, you're not going to win any games having that many penalties. And,
no.
And then, you know, being better in the red zone. All those things you can control as a team. So, you know, we're getting to a point where, you know, the expectations are that, you know, you go in there and compete with, and give yourself a chance to win in the fourth quarter. So, excited about the opportunity. Coach Lambert, like I said, has done a great job, and really want to encourage all of our fans right up 77 there and watch us play.
All righty, Coach Harold Nichols, always a pleasure to visit with you. I think it's going to be an exciting season, no doubt. Oh, by the way, a lot of freshmen played last Saturday. How many?
Well, you know, we had 10 redshirt freshmen playing
right.
the game, and then 8 true freshmen, so a total of 18. So that kind of bodes well for the future. You know, like I say, we'll need as much depth as we can during the course of the year, but no doubt, we played some young kids.
With that, for Coach Harold Nichols, I'm Eric Thacker. Till then, go Blue Hose.
Inside Blue Hose Football was brought to you by Smith Chevrolet of Lawrence, providing premier new car sales and service in Lawrence for over 60 years. By Palmetto Bone and Joint, the official orthopedic care provider for PC Athletics. And by Carolina Fresh Farms, the official turf grass of Presbyterian College. We would like to thank the following Blue Hose Honor Roll sponsors. The Bud Group. Good Times Entertainment. Carolina Concrete. Enterprise Rent-A-Car. Midway Barbecue. Hannah Heating and Air Conditioning. Epting Turf and Tractor. Arthur State Bank. Carolina Auto Sales of Clinton. Wilson's Cafe. Tony's Pizza and Steamer's Cafe.